Welcome to the University of Rochester Pathology video series. My name is Elian Grace, and I will be reviewing the normal histology of the kidney. Within the University of Rochester's NanoZoomer digital pathology slides, slide 134 is located within the normal tissue for DPT and host defense folder. Feel free to locate slide 134 and follow along as we explore a section of the kidney. The kidney is histologically divided into two regions, the inner medulla and outer cortex. The renal medulla is composed of renal pyramids, and grossly the tissue appears striated because it's more... made up of microscopic tubules. The renal cortex grossly appears more granular. The function of the kidney is to regulate body fluid volume, composition, and pH by taking metabolic wastes out of blood and excreting them outside of the body. The functional unit of the kidney is the nephron. Nephrons are tiny and composed of the renal corpuscle and renal tubule. The renal corpuscle is made up of a filtering unit called the glomerulus and the Bowman's capsule, which collects the filtrate. The afferent arteriole carries blood to the glomerulus, while the efferent arteriole carries blood away. Histologically, we can sometimes see these arterioles, but not always. When we do, they have a structure similar to other arterioles, with a thin endothelial layer. Blood that is brought through the afferent arteriole is filtered by the glomerulus into the capsular space. The glomerulus prevents blood cells, proteins, and other large molecules from passing into the capsular space, while water and molecules that are small are able to pass through. Microscopically, the glomerulus is composed of the fenestrated endothelium, the glomerular basement membrane, and podocytes. Not all of these are evident on a standard H&E microscopy, but you can identify how the glomerulus is composed of specialized capillaries with red blood cells in some of the vascular spaces. Mesangial cells can be identified. These are a type of myofibroblastic cell which functions to support and regulate the glomerular tuft. We can also identify that there is flattened parietal epithelium which lines Bowman's space. From the capsular space, the filtrate passes through a channel into the renal tubule, which is a series of ducts in the nephron. The first part of the renal tubule that the filtrate passes through is the proximal convoluted tubule. This is located in the cortex of the kidney and is the longest part of the renal tubule. It is composed of simple cuboidal epithelium with a border of microvilli. Substances that the proximal convoluted tubule reabsorbs back into the blood include glucose, amino acids, water, sodium, potassium, phosphate, and chloride. Next, the remaining filtrate passes through the loop of Henle. The loop of Henle is hard to tell apart from nearby capillaries, but a key difference is that there are no red blood cells in the lumen of the loop of Henle. The lumen is made up of simple squamous epithelium. The thin descending lumen of the loop of Henle functions to reabsorb water that was able to pass through the proximal convoluted tubule. The thin and thick ascending limbs of Henle reabsorb ions such as sodium, chloride, and potassium. After going through the thick ascending limb of Henle, the filtrate passes through the distal convoluted tubule. These tubules are less numerous than the proximal tubules, and they consist of cuboidal epithelium that don't have many microvilli. The distal convoluted tubule reabsorbs calcium, sodium, and chloride while also secreting protons and absorbing bicarbonate in order to regulate the pH of urine. Lastly, the filtrate passes through collecting tubules. Collecting tubules are not part of the nephron, and they are made up of either cuboidal or columnar epithelium. Connecting tubules empty into collecting ducts that have large lumens so they can be recognized under a microscope by this large lumen. The connecting tubules concentrate the filtrate further and transport it to larger ducts that connect to renal calyces. From the calyces, urine passes through the major calyx to the renal pelvis and then into the ureters.